Dear brothers and sisters, as we all look at our lives, find that life brings many, many challenges. There are times when things are not working as we'd like them to work. We might have a physical problem. We might have a financial problem. There could be someone who we're very close to who's passed away. And emotional states are such that it's very difficult to deal with that separation. We also, as we pass through life, find that sometimes things at work might not be as good. And so, as life goes on, we find many, many challenges are coming to us from all kinds of directions. And many people who are trying to find God, who are trying to sit in silence, who are trying to meditate, find that the difficulties of life become a hindrance in their spiritual progress. When they close their eyes, instead of being able to focus on what is in front of them, they are bombarded by thoughts. And then they get entangled in those thoughts. And so how are we to deal with that situation? With the aspects of our outer life are impacting our inner spiritual journey. I'd like to start with the story. This is a story about a man who'd been meditating to find God. So he had learned that to know God we need to sit in silence, we need to meditate. So he tried meditation. And he tried it for a while. And every time he closed his eyes, he would get some kind of a thought. And he tried to meditate, but he could not get the thought away. And so, after trying for a few years, he was at a point where he was ready to give up. At that time, he just heard from one of his friends that a saint was in town, and this saintly person helped people find out about God. So since he really wanted to see God, experience God, be with God, he decided to go and meet the saint. So he got an audience with the saint. And while he was in the presence of this saintly person, he asked the saint how he can find God. So the saint very humbly told him that for you to find God, you should stay in the company of someone who's found God himself and learn from them and emulate their life into your own life. And so this man who was searching for God, he asked the saint, who is it who's attained God and where can I find this person so I can stay with him and find out what he does all day? And so the saintly person gave him a name and an address. So go to this and this address and find this and this person. And the next day, early in the morning, this man ventures out, goes to the town of the person whose address was given to him, and he's searching. And he finds the place and he knocks on the door. And the door is opened by someone who's wearing like work clothes, who's got a pipe in his hand, and who's got a bottle of liquid in the other hand. And the person who was searching for God thought, I must be at the wrong address, because he's looking for a saintly person. He says, oh, I'm sorry, maybe I got the wrong address. And so the person who opened the door asked him, you know, what address are you looking for? And the person takes the address out and reads it out to him and says, this is the house I'm in. And who are you looking for? So he took his name. He said, yeah, this is me. Now this man got really puzzled on the inside. He had thought he was to be meeting a saintly person, learn about spirituality and see how he can know God. And he starts to think to himself, how is this person going to help me? He looks like someone who's like a working person. And so the person who's searching for God starts to talk about why he's there. And he said, this saint sent me here to learn about spirituality and to know God. But I don't know how you can help me, because you look like someone who just is like a worker. And so the person who to him looked like a worker said, yeah, I'm a plumber by profession. I clean pipes, I fix sinks. And you know, if the saint sent you here, there must be something right. There must be something for you to see and to put in your life. So what I can do is I can have you stay in one of my rooms, and you can stay here a week, and you can see how I live and see if you learn anything. And so the next day, this person who's come to search for God realizes that the plumber gets up early in the morning and he sits to meditate for a couple of hours. And after he's meditated, he gets ready to go to work. And so this man also goes with the plumber to see what he does all day. So as he is with the plumber all day, he realizes that this plumber is a very jovial person. Everyone that he meets, he talks very nicely to them. And wherever he goes, there's some kind of a problem. Either someone's sink is clogged, or someone has some other problem in their bathrooms or in their kitchens. And he also notices that every time there's some kind of a problem, it seems like the plumber takes this bottle that he has and pours out a liquid. And all of a sudden, as he's pouring the liquid out, the problem which is there, which is blocking the sink or the bathroom, all of a sudden clears up. And people get happy with his work. And the plumber gets home at night, he has dinner, and after dinner, before going to bed, he sits in meditation for a little while too. And so this goes on one day, and the second day, and the third day. Even though the kind of homes that the plumber is going to are different, but the work is quite similar, because he's always there to try to fix some kind of a plumbing problem that someone else has. And every day is going by, and this man is thinking, what am I learning? I know that this liquid that he has is good. It seems to take care of all the plumbing problems that most people have. And so as 7 days are gone, the person in himself is thinking, I don't know what this saintly person told me. Maybe he didn't even know about God, and so just to get away, he sent me to this plumber and had a week wasted of mine. And so on the last day, as he's leaving, the plumber asks him, did you gain something from your experience? And the person who was searching for God said, I don't think I gained anything. And I don't know why the saints sent me here. Because all I see is that you're a very happy person, you're a joyful person, you try to bring good things into the life of others, you're talking about good things to people, you're making the atmosphere better, you're taking off their problems, and I see you pouring this liquid down the drain, and I can maybe take the name of this liquid, so if I have a plumbing problem, that would help me, but I don't know what else I can gain from your life. So the plumber said, I don't know if this will help you, but let me tell you a story. And this is a story that the plumber told him. He said, many years ago, I went to this saintly person who sent you to me. And I wanted to know God. And the saint asked me what my profession was. And I told him that I was a plumber. So the saint told me that just like you have a pipe, whether it's in a sink or in any other place, with filth and grime it gets clogged. Because you're putting in one object or another object, and it's not able to pass through the pipe. And then you take some liquid which is powerful enough to get rid of the dirt and grime, so it passes through and the pure water starts to pass through the pipe again. He said, that's who you are. That you are a pipe, a plumbing pipe. And what happens is, because of your thoughts all day, your system is getting to be filled up. And with time, lust and anger and greed and attachment and ego, they overtake your life. You have hatred, you have jealousies in your life. And what they're doing is they're clogging your pipe. And what you need is a cleansing liquid. And that is within you. And that is the power of God within you. Whether you call it the divine light inside of God, whether you call it the holy word, whether you call it the Naam or the Shabd or the Kalma, it's that creative power which brought all creation to being, and that's within yourself. And so when you connect with it, the cleansing of your pipe happens, and the connection with this holy light and sound of God happens as you meditate. The process of meditation is one in which you are connecting with this divine power of God which brought you here, which brought all creation to being. And so, as an individual, you have a choice. You have a choice either to keep on clogging your system up, and we all know when our plumbing is clogged, nothing works. So, or you can unclog the system so things flow smoothly and the water keeps on flowing properly. And to unclog your system, we need to meditate. And he said, this is why I meditate in the morning and I meditate at night before going to bed. Because all day long I'm busy taking care of one problem or another or another. It was then that the person who'd gone to find out about God started to realize what truly was important. He looked at his own life and realized that he has thoughts coming to him whenever he's trying to sit to meditate. he also started to realize that some of the thoughts are negative and some of the thoughts are positive. But he realized that whether it was a negative thought or a positive thought, they were all taking his attention away from being able to meditate properly, because instead of meditating, he was thinking. He was focused into the thought. And so what is very important is for us to realize that as we start to go on a search for God, the difficulties are bound to come along the way. It is how we deal with our difficulties, how we deal with our problems, which reflect on what our journey would be like. If we keep stuck to the thoughts and have no mechanism of getting away from the thoughts, then we'll never be able to rise above physical body consciousness. The thoughts are going to come one after another after another. Desires in life start to be more and more and more. You try to get one thing and then you want two, you get two, you want four, you have four, you want eight. You do what you think is good in one area, then you want to do good in another area, want to do good in another area. But what areas are we focusing on? If our focus is only on the world outside, then we are not gaining anything for ourselves. If our focus is only in the physical body, then our focus is only in that what is temporary. This physical body is going to deteriorate 50, 60, 80, 100 years. We need to focus our attention not on the body, but on our soul, on the power that gives life to the body, because the soul is eternal. And that focus on our soul is what true meditation is all about. And that focus can only come in if we can pierce through the wall of the body and the mind. It's the body and the mind which are barriers for us, which keep us away from knowing God. And this is why as we meditate, we're asked to keep the body still. Have no distraction. Don't move the body. Don't have your hand be in the hand of someone else, and just stay still. So that the physical body is not distracting us. And then it's our mind which sends us thoughts. So we ask to focus our mind on God. Because if the mind is going to be focused on the body itself and its interactions with everyone else in the world, then all we'll get is one thought after another after another. It could be what we've done yesterday, it could be what we have to do tomorrow, it could be an experience that we, you know, think gave us happiness, or say something that gave us pain, but it'll be everything of the world outside. And any thought is a distraction. So we need to keep away from the focus on our body and our mind. So we do a mental repetition of God's name. So we take our mind and focus it on God. Why? Because we want to know God, we want to be with God, we want to experience God, we want to go on the spiritual journey. And so this person realized that as we meditate, we need a mechanism to still the mind after we've stilled the body. And that is by repeating God's name mentally. So as we meditate, as we are able to still the body, as we repeat God's name, what happens is that we are then able to get to a state where the distractions from the body and the mind are not going to bother us. And it's in that state that we've crossed the barriers that the body and the mind is placing in front of us, and we've gotten to a region of light, a spiritual region. a region which is full of the light and the love of the Creator. And as we keep our attention focused right in front of us, whether to us it seems like flashes of lights or circles of light or lights of various colors or a sky full of stars or an inner sun or an inner moon or many other vista within. It's our attention which needs to get to that state for us to be connected with the divine power within and for us to be uplifted from the physical to the divine, go on the spiritual journey. A journey of love, a journey of light. Now, that journey is available to each and every one of us. The cleansing power which cleanses grime and dirt which has been sitting on our soul for eons and eons is all within ourselves. The light and sound of God is within ourselves, not coming from the outside. But we need to go through the barriers which are keeping us from getting to it. And so you need to connect with the divine light and sound of God within. You need to connect with the divine liquid which is within ourselves, so that each and every pore of our being can be cleansed, so that the divine light can flow through us easily, and as it flows through us, it uplifts us. And as we go on the spiritual journey, it is then that we experience God. Because the two primal manifestations of God are the divine light and the divine sound of God. So let us meditate for a few minutes. Sit as comfortably as you can. Close your eyes very gently, just like you close them when you go to sleep. Your eyeball should be straight, focused 8 or 10 inches in front of you. And as you close your eyes, those of you who have been initiated in the mysteries of the beyond, please do your simran. And those of you who are new here, please repeat any name of God that you feel comfortable with. As we repeat God's name, we'll find that right in front of us, light will sprout forth. So keep our attention right in the middle of the experience. And many inner vistas will open up for us. I pray to God Almighty and to the three great masters of the past century, Hazur Baba Savan Singh Ji Maharaj, Param Sant Kripal Singh Ji Maharaj, and the gracious Master Sant Darshan Singh Ji Maharaj, to help each and every one of us here connect with the creative power within ourselves, to experience the divine light in its effulgence. I will be sitting for a few minutes. I'll be getting you out of this meditative state at that time. And my best wishes are with each and every one of you. Please leave off, Chordi Jeji.